As 2017 comes to an end, Venezuelans will say goodbye to it the same way they welcomed it, without cash. Januaria Verde spent more than 2 hours today trying to get money out of an ATM. She lined up at 3 machines. The first had no cash left. At the second, she got 10,000 bolivars, and finally, 20,000 at the third. That's worth about 3 US cents on the black market, not even enough to pay for her taxi ride home.
Getting cash in Venezuela has become a nightmare. Even if you're lucky enough to get some money from the bank or ATMs one day, that money is not enough. We have no control over our own money.
Venezuela's money supply has recently risen to a record amount. The government keeps printing money, and it's fueling the world's highest rate of inflation. The IMF predicts it will catapult from triple digits this year to 2,350% in 2018.
The government has a large deficit. It wants to spend more money and has no way to do it. Only 10% of the state's expenditures are being financed with taxes. The rest comes from loans from the Central Bank of Venezuela. That money is used to close the country's deficit, but that same money is devalued within 20 days, causing hyperinflation.
Venezuela receives 96% of its foreign currency from the exports of oil. And since the fall in oil prices in 2014, the Venezuelan economy has contracted 10%. Now, it's struggling to avoid default on its debts. According to the IMF, Venezuela has external debt of $150 billion, with foreign reserves under $10 billion. And by the end of this year, Venezuela needs to pay $3 billion to its bondholders. The government has blamed the economic crisis on an international conspiracy and economic sanctions imposed by the U.S. 5 months ago. They limit Venezuela's ability to borrow money. But President Nicolas Maduro says he has a plan. It revolves around a new virtual currency called the Petro.
We're to implement a new cryptocurrency system based on oil reserves to advance in terms of monetary sovereignty. This will allow us to advance to new forms of international financing.
Experts say it's unlikely the virtual currency would summon enough investor confidence to help Venezuela raise the money it needs to pay off its debts. So the reality for millions of Venezuelans in 2018 is they'll still be standing in lines hoping ATMs will dispense the money they need to put food on their tables. Juan Carlos Lamas, TRT World, Caracas.